Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So, finally, I managed to clear this Bariura map. It's already a week actually, since the first release. Well, my bad. I'm kinda lazy to do normal quests, so yeah, I just finished it. I didn't store energy to clear this quest, so I was just waiting for the energy to refill, and I started to do the quest again and again. So finally here, Subterranean cave. Oh, the first time I touch it, so the story is still there. It looks like you've made your way safely inside the cave. Just getting in there was difficult enough, wasn't it? Not really? Okay, but it only gets tougher from this point on. Are you sure? Well, let me explain the details of this particular request. I'm Lin Maryholm from Logistics Support. Run Gaia Survey Office Bureau of Immigration and at your service. Okay? The destruction of the power that controls Bariura has influenced change in the environment there. I'm sure you have already heard this, but they said that an amazing summoner has defeated all the four fallen gods. That's me? No. However, the consequence of this chain of people had led to many magical awakening very dangerous demons and gods in the process. The request we have for you now is one of these cases. A dormant beast in Bariura has been awakened. Oh, okay. And even though the four fallen have been defeated, many perils still exist in this world. Grand Gaia is indeed a dangerous place. So we are very grateful to you for battling your way through it, Ushi. Oh yeah, you're welcome. By the way, so let's just skip it. That's too long. Okay, so here is the extra dungeon. Yep. So this time I will do it with... Okay, let's use a receipt of bread. Well, it's a full 6-star score. Well, I got complained about making a video using a full 7 stars. Yeah. Well, of course, you have all those good 7 stars. Of course, you can clear it easily. So, this time, I will use all 6 stars. And if you want to clear very, very quick and easy, you can actually use this kind of squad. Yep. Okay, so for now, I will go with this squad. Arbonella is my leader. Darwin Shell. Michelle, Yuji, Zell Knight, and Rosetta Flynn. Okay guys, so let's begin the quest. So I will skip the minions battle, so I'm just gonna go straight to the boss stage to make the video length shorter. Okay guys, so it's the boss battle now. Warning. Okay, oops, my auto battle is still on. Forgot to turn it off. Can't help anything by this. So I'm gonna turn it off, by the way. Okay, so here is the boss, Earth Element, WST-1096. Okay, so what's special about this boss? He will do an AoE ultimate attack every 6 turns, so you have to do the turn counting. By the way, it's turn 2 now. Second turn. Okay, third turn. Okay, Ooh. Ooh, so hard. Okay. Turn 4 now. Turn 5 now. You have to be careful to not make his HP under half, since he will also do an ultimate attack once his HP goes to half. Okay, that was turn 5, by the way. Okay, next turn is the 6th turn, so I will just guard my units. Make sure you have high HP. Like this. It's the 6th turn. And on the next turn, he will do an ultimate attack, I think. So what am I going to do is to make sure that my unit has high enough HP. So I'm gonna do something like this. The turn counting back to turn 1 by the way. Ah, the damage was not enough. Ooh, so good. Okay, one second. Turn 2 by the way. Okay, so I'm gonna drop the other units. Turn 3, by the way. Okay. Okay, turn 4. Okay, turn 5. Okay, the reason why I brought UJU is because so that I can have high HP when I guard all of my units. My Arbonella might kinda die though. I just got them all. Arbonella doesn't have enough HP, so she died. Okay, so back to turn 1, guys. Alright. So I guess I can kill it before I reach the other third turn. Yeah, I mean the other 6th turn. It's turn 3 right away. Turn 4. Okay, turn 5. And it's the end. It's the end of the world. Okay. Okay. So I cleared it. Oh, 6 star. Are you satisfied? Just kidding. Okay, guys, so that was how to beat this dungeon with all 6 stars. Just in case if you don't have enough cores or you don't have any 7 stars yet. Okay. Okay, so the bonus is Spirit Rock. The story is too long, by the way. Come on. And by the way, if you want to endure the AoE ultimate attack every 6 turns, you have to use a leader that can reduce 15% of Earth attacks from Earth enemies. If you don't, you will certainly die. The damage is based on your HP percentage, so it doesn't matter how many HP do you have, it will reduce a certain percentage of your max HP. So if, I don't know, I forgot about the calculation though. I've explained about this on my walkthrough video on my Japan version back then. So guys, that's all about the Tech Stars squad to beat this dungeon. Okay, so let's use this squad this time. Let's see if I can win it with this or not. Okay, FIFA as leader, eternal armor and solo creator. Aaron, Claire, Cole, Quake, and Rosetta Friend. Okay, so I'm gonna go with this squad. Begin the quest. Okay guys, so here's the boss. Okay, this time, well, let's just make it simple and easy like this. And let the auto battle go. Okay, well, I don't really have to bring Claire actually, since Rosetta can only give this part damage up buff, and the battle crystal, heart crystal, I can get it from FIFA. But if I bring Claire, my Cold will get all stats plus 30%, which is very good. And yeah, do not forget to bring holy water, since this monster can actually curse you. Okay. Second turn, by the way. So, this boss can do AoE instant death ultimate attack every 6 turn. So as long as you can kill it under 6 turn, the ultimate attack won't be there. It's the third turn, by the way. So the key of using this kind of squad is actually about... Oops, dead. Rosetta is dead. As long as you can do unlimited XPB, it's okay. And good damage, of course. That's why I brought Rosetta friend. If you can find a Raga friend, or if you have your own Raga, you can use Raga as leader friend to get even higher finish than just using a Rosetta friend. Okay, so it's the end. Oops, doesn't matter though. Okay, it's the end. Yep. So this is how the battle turns out if you're using a full 7 stars. It's much easier than using full 6 stars, just like what I did before. I think this dungeon was created for seven, I mean for 6 stars on Japan server back then. There were no 7 stars, I guess. No, no 7 stars yet, I guess. Back then. So that's how they do it, guys. You can bring something like that, and do not forget holy water. The status ailments is only curse, I think, and attack down, defend down, and such. But holy water is enough for this. Okay, guys. So maybe that's all for now. And if you haven't do this dungeon, you have your choice to use Arbonella squad or just YOLO it with unlimited SDP score. Okay, guys, so maybe that's all for now, guys. Thank you for watching. See you again next time, and bye bye.